हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मिस्टर मुंडे टीजी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन केमिस्ट्री एट संजीवनी कॉलेज चापोली। आफ्टर लुकिंग डीपली इनटू द सिलेबस फ्रॉम टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू द कंटेंट ऑफ द सिलेबस and we will see one by one topic, and the first topic is synthetic drugs and dyes. This chapter is very important for your further studies, and if you want to do PG in drug and dye chemistry at that time, this topic is very important. So this topic constitutes two parts. One is synthetic drugs and another is synthetic dyes. First we will see synthetic drugs. And initially we have to see what is meant by a drug. Generally, when we fall ill or we suffer from some disease or pain, at that time we go to the counter and take some medications and we get relief from the suffering. And these medications are nothing but drugs. It has very long history, and the drugs are used since ancient times. So for our day-to-day life, if we want to relieve ourselves from painful sufferings, at that time we must know the chemistry of drugs. Then what is drug? In Greek language, a drug means ड्राय हर्ब. आपल्याकडं वाळेला जो झाडपाला असतो, आयुर्वेदामध्ये जो वापरला जातो ना, तो म्हणजेच ड्रग आहे. आणि त्यालाच ग्रीक लँग्वेजमध्ये देखील ड्रग म्हणतात. ड्रग मीन्स ड्राय हर्ब. बट दिस इज ओल्डर अजम्पशन. And nowadays, according to WHO, the definition is any substance which is used for modifying or exploring physiological system or physiological state, pathological state, for the benefit of recipient is known as drug. Is known as drug. A drug means any substance, anything that can benefit or modify our health system and there is another definition, and that is a general definition. The definition is a substance which is used in prevention, diagnosis, treatment or cure of a disease in a man is known as drug. Any substance that is used to cure a disease or to relieve pain is known as a drug. So you can go through both the definitions. Both are useful for in the view of your examination. You can write any one of the two definitions. It is better to write the definition prescribed by who. Then there are many drugs which are useful to our health system, but many of them have many side effects. So that for a drug to be good, there are some conditions or there are some characteristics, ideal characteristics of a drug that can be satisfied. And these characteristics are it should be non-toxic. It should be non-toxic. The first preferred condition or the characteristic of a drug, good drug, is that it should be non-toxic. It means it should not harm to the host. There are many drugs which are useful in one disease, but they have some side effects in another disease. For example, for our to relieve our pain or to lower the fever, we take paracetamol as analgesic or antipyretic or anti-inflammatory agent. If you consumed this paracetamol in excess amount at that time, it harms to your liver. So that there is no drug which is perfectly ideal. There is no drug which is perfectly ideal. So the first case is, or the first characteristic is, it should not be toxic. The second characteristic is, when a host consumes the drug, at that time the drug should be specific in its action. It means when a drug is administered to the host, it should act on the a specific part of the body which is suffering. It should not happen that you have pain in head and or you have a headache and your drug is acting on your skin. It should not happen. म्हणजे आपल्याकडे एक म्हण आहे बघा की दुखणं हल्याला आणि इंजेक्शन पखालीला. या म्हणीनुसार भलतीकडेच आपलं जे काही ड्रग असेल ते ड्रग काम केलं जाऊ नये. म्हणून जे काही तुम्ही ड्रग घेताय किंवा कन्झ्युम करताय ते ड्रग त्याच्या ॲक्शनमध्ये स्पेसिफिक असलं पाहिजे. डोकं दुखत असेल तर डोक्यावरतीच त्याचा परिणाम झाला पाहिजे, त्याचा परिणाम इतर पार्ट्सवरती नाही झाला पाहिजे. आता या कॅरेक्टरिस्टिकच्या नंतर तिसरं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक काय आहे, इट शुड बी सेफ अँड एफिशियंट. म्हणजे काय तर की जे काही तुम्ही ड्रग घेताय हे ड्रग सेफ असलं पाहिजे, म्हणजे त्याने कुठल्याही पद्धतीचा जो कोणी घेणारा पेशंट आहे त्याला हार्म नाही केलं पाहिजे. म्हणजे डोकं दुखण्यासाठी आपण गोळी घेतली आणि जर का समजा आपल्याला उलट्या व्हायला लागल्या तर त्याला काय अर्थ आहे. म्हणजे ते हार्मफुल नसलं पाहिजे. काही काही केसेसमध्ये तर एखादं इंजेक्शन किंवा कुठलंही ड्रग घेतल्याच्यानंतर पेशंट दगावू देखील शकतो. त्या ड्रगचं किंवा इंजेक्शनचं रिॲक्शन येऊन तो पेशंट देखील दगावू शकतो. म्हणून इट शुड बी सेफ अँड एफिशियंट. आता एफिशियंट म्हणजे कसा, तर समजा एखादं औषध घेतल्याच्यानंतर तो औषध किंवा ड्रग एका टाईम लिमिटमध्ये काम केला पाहिजे. आपण म्हणतो ना यू नो इट वर्क्स इन 6 सेकंड्स. म्हणजे कोणाला जर का ॲसिडिटी झाली असेल आणि जळजळ होत असेल तर त्याने जाऊन कुठलं तरी एखादं औषध घ्यायचं आणि मग त्याचं जर का 4-5 तासाच्या नंतर ॲक्शन होत असेल आणि ती ॲक्शन पण स्लो असेल तर त्याला कुठलाही अर्थ नाही. हां, रिलीव मिळते परंतु इट इज व्हेरी लेट. परंतु तेच जर का समजा ॲसिडिटी झालेली असेल आणि तेच तुम्हाला 5-10 मिनटामध्ये रिलीव मिळत असेल तर दॅट इज एफिशियन्सी ऑफ दॅट ड्रग. म्हणजे एखादं पर्टिक्युलर जे काही तुम्ही ड्रग घेताय ते किती स्पेसिफिक आहे आणि किती स्पीडने काम करतं, किती वेगाने काम करतं याला देखील महत्त्व आहे. तर हे येऊ इतके सगळे कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पाहिल्याच्यानंतर आपण नेक्स्ट बघणार आहोत इट शूड हॅव मिनिमम साईड इफेक्ट्स. म्हणजे त्याचे कमीत कमी साईड इफेक्ट्स असले पाहिजेत. देन इट शूड नॉट इंज्युअर द होस्ट टिश्यू ऑर फिजिओलॉजिकल प्रोसेस. मीन्स द ड्रग यू आर कन्झ्युमिंग शूड नॉट अल्टर युअर फिजिओलॉजिकल प्रोसेस. ॲज आय सेड prior to this that if you are suffering from headache and you consume a tablet and suddenly you have vomitings, it should not happen. Then the next is the cells should not acquire tolerance or resistance to the drug after prolonged use. It means there are many drugs, after continuous consumption of those drugs, they become resistant to the drugs, or the cells become resistant to the drugs. For example, if a TB patient takes some first stage drugs for a period of 15 to 30 days and after it he discontinues and then if he suffers after some time, at that time the first stage drugs do not work. It means the cells have now prepared to resist the drugs so that the first stage medications do not work in the tuberculosis second time. So all these were the characteristics of an ideal drug. It is not possible to have a ideal drug, to have an ideal drug. But the scientists are continuously trying to develop new and safer drugs for the wellness of the human being. The second point is classification of drugs based on therapeutic actions. The drugs have been classified into many types, as you have seen in your 12th standard also. The first type is functional drugs. Then what are functional drugs? The drugs which act on various physiological functions of the body are known as functional drugs. It means the drug or the functional drug changes your physiological process or physiological function of the body. And these drugs are analgesics, antipyretics, anesthetics, antidiabetics, anti-inflammatory, sedatives, hypnotics, and tranquilizers. Further, these functional drugs have their proper functions, and some of them have multi-purpose. Some of them are multi-purpose. And the first is analgesics. What is meant by analgesic? A drug that relieves pain of the body is known as analgesic. Analgesics relieves pain. If you have headache, toothache, leg ache, or backache, any body part ache at that time, these analgesics reduces the pain. And the examples are paracetamol, aspirin, benzocaine, then diclofenac, all these. The next is antipyretic. A drug that reduces or lower the fever are known as antipyretic drugs. The antipyretic drugs lowers fever when you have high fever or body temperature. At that time, they change or they interfere with your physiological functioning and lowers the body temperature. And the examples of antipyretic are paracetamol, aspirin. The next is anesthetic. What is meant by anesthetic? A drug that gives temporary loss of sense or awareness. A drug that produces temporary loss of sense or awareness is known as anesthetic. It means it also relieves your suffering, or makes you senseless. I'm not saying that it makes you nonsense, but it makes you senseless. So when you go through a surgery or major operations, at that time you require anesthesia. म्हणजेच काय, तुम्ही जेव्हा एखाद्या ऑपरेशनसाठी किंवा सर्जरीसाठी जात असता त्यावेळी तुम्हाला भूल दिली जाते आणि ही भूल देण्यासाठी जी काय औषधं वापरली जातात त्यांना आपण ॲनेस्थेटिक्स म्हणतो. आणि हे ॲनेस्थेटिक्स काय करतात, तर तुमच्या बॉडीच्या एखाद्या पार्टचा किंवा संपूर्ण बॉडीचा तात्पुरता जो सेन्स असतो किंवा जे काय अवेअरनेस असतो तो लॉस करतात, म्हणजेच त्याला मिटवतात किंवा त्याला सेन्सलेस करून टाकतात तुमच्या एखाद्या बॉडी पार्टला. आणि असे जे ड्रग्ज असतात जे की आपल्या बॉडी पार्ट्सला भूल देण्यासाठी वापरले जातात त्यांना आपण ॲनेस्थेटिक्स म्हणतो. आणि एक्झाम्पल्स आहेत, बेंझोकेन्स केन असेल, किंवा जुन्या काळी म्हणण्यापेक्षा एक 15-20 वर्षापूर्वी आपण क्लोरोफॉर्म वापरला जायचा, त्याच्यानंतर डायथिल इथर वापरला जायचा ॲज अ ॲनेस्थेटिक म्हणून. आता भरपूर अल्किल हॅलाइड्स आलेले आहेत जे की सेफ आहेत ॲनेस्थेटिक म्हणून वापरले जाण्यासाठी. तर असे हे ॲनेस्थेटिक्स पाहिल्याच्यानंतर आपण नेक्स्ट बघूयात अँटीडायबेटिक्स. अँटीडायबेटिक्स मीन्स ए ड्रग दॅट इज यूज टू कंट्रोल द शुगर लेवल इन द ब्लड. ए ड्रग दॅट इज यूज टू कंट्रोल द शुगर लेवल इन ब्लड. दोज पेशंट्स सफरिंग फ्रॉम sugar, it could be either or higher or lower, they can be brought to normal level, or their sugar can be controlled by using antidiabetic drugs. And these drugs have also some side effects, and the examples are, or the example is, insulin. The patient suffering from sugar is suggested to take insulin injections in addition to some other medications. After antidiabetics, we are going to now anti-inflammatory drugs. The drugs which reduces inflammation or swelling of the body are known as anti-inflammatory drugs. For example, paracetamol, aspirin, or benzocaine. The next is sedatives. The drugs that slow down brain activity and make you feel relaxed are known as sedatives. The sedatives directly affects our central nervous system and relaxes our brain activity or slows down our brain activity so that we feel relaxed. And these drugs that are used to feel relaxed or to become tensionless are known as sedatives. Next is hypnotics. The drugs which are used to induce sleep are known as hypnotic drugs. These drugs are used in insomnia disease or to relax a person who is tempered. There are many hypnotic drugs that are used for the sleeping, and we generally call it as sleeping pills. Then the next is tranquilizers. The drugs which are used to reduce anxiety or tension are known as tranquilizers. These tranquilizers belongs to hypnotic categories because all these three, sedatives, hypnotics and tranquilizers, directly affect our central nervous system and relaxes our body, and it makes to feel us tensionless or reduced anxiety. The second classification is chemotherapeutic agents. The first was functional drugs, then the next is chemotherapeutic agents. The treatment of infectious disease by using a chemical agent is known as chemotherapy, and the substance employed in is known as chemotherapeutic agent. The diseases caused by infections are known as infectious diseases, or we say it as the diseases that are spread through contacts. To treat these infectious diseases, we use some specific medications or drugs, and these drugs are known as chemotherapeutic agents. And the first type is, or the first chemotherapeutic agent is antimalarials. The drugs that are used to prevent from malaria are known as malarials, antimalarials. It means that the drugs that are used to treat malaria are known as antimalarials. Chloroquine is the drug that is used to treat malaria. In monsoon days, many rural peoples suffer from malaria due to biting by mosquitoes, and to treat the malaria we use some drugs such as ampicillin, chloroquine, and in addition to these other drugs as antimalarials. The next is antibacterials. The drugs that are used to kill or stop the growth of bacteria are known as antibacterials drugs. These drugs inhibit the growth of bacteria in our body. For example, ampicillin or cefaxime. The next is antifungals. The drugs which are used to kill or stop the growth of fungi are known as antifungals or antifungal drugs. If a patient suffers from fungal diseases such as Tinea capitis or dermatitis or chlorosis, at that time these antifungals are used to stop the fungus or to kill the fungus present on the body of a patient. And the examples are Gracilaprevin, Fluconazole, Itraconazole or any other fungal drug, antifungal drug. The next is anti-tuberculars. The drugs which are used to treat tuberculosis disease are known as anti-tuberculars. The patients who are suffering from TB or tuberculosis, these are advised to have some drugs, and those drugs are known as anti-tubercular drugs. So if you have any query related to this topic, you can ask me on my WhatsApp or you can call me. My number is available for your sake of reference or for your ease on WhatsApp. So go through all those topics and best luck. Thank you.